Taking a look at our starting lineups for Seton Hall, Kadidra Simmons out of Shabazz High School. Newark runs the show at the point with Tabitha Richardson-Smith, Roche Ali, a Connect Kentucky transfer, Sydney Cook, and Janae Johnson. For St. John's, their lineup has been a little bit in flux. Hanford, though, is the star. Sandra Udobe making her second straight start. So for the St. John's Red Storm, Scott, great hope and optimism after that big victory over Texas A&M at the Garden. A back and forth game, St. John's winning it 72-70. The hoop by Aaliyah Hanford with 2 seconds to go. But now it's brand new. It's conference play.
Well, both records now are 0-0. The non-league records go out the window until March, come postseason.
Amber Thompson will jump it up against Janae Johnson of Seton Hall. Ed Sedlaski, Joanne Aldridge, Tiara Cruz will do the honors. And it will be St. John's to open up with possession to start us off in the home white-on-white unis. Seton Hall in the blue-on-blue. The two teams met a year ago. And St. John's winning 2 out of 3 meetings, including in the Big East second round in the tournament. Seton Hall in a zone look as Hanford inside. And she was stripped by Kadidra Simmons, her former high school teammate at Shabazz High School. Hanford was a sophomore when Simmons was a senior, as Shabazz won the New Jersey Tournament of Champions title now 4 years ago. Here is Udobe, shot clock to 7. Brown into the lane, and the floater goes off glass.
And I'll tell you, what a difference a week and a half makes for St. John's. They have shown so much more poise on the offensive end, setting great screens and getting to the basket.
And here's St. John's also coming out in a zone look, something they featured exclusively in the win over Texas A&M at Madison Square Garden. Richardson-Smith fires the pass inside of the shot, altered on Johnson by Udobe, and out of bounds off of Seton Hall.
Well, that 2-3 zone that St. John's has put in now, it's a very active matchup 2-3 zone, and they could extend it as far out as they want if they deem a shooter that they want to take away a look. And that's what they did against Texas A&M. They exploited their weakness, and their weakness was the 3-point shot.
Foul against Tabitha Richardson-Smith. Outside. For Seton Hall, renewed optimism because Anthony Becella, a Seton Hall alum and a class of 1989, is in his first season taking over after a wonderful run, particularly the last 8 years building the Iona program.
I go back ways with Tony Becella, and I remember him at LIU Southampton. He was coaching the women's side. I was coaching the men at Dowling at the time, and then he moved on to LIU and then to Iona, and everywhere he's gone, he's built the program.
Janae Johnson from the outside. That's off, and Brianna Brown, the rebound. And they're ready at 8-2. A Seton Hall team that went 11-20 last year, 5-11, of course, in a much different looking Big East than with Notre Dame and UConn and Louisville, among others. Here inside is Sandra Udobe, making her second straight start, the first two of her career for the sophomore from Nigeria.
And Udobe looks so much different than she did a month ago. She's playing with so much confidence now.
Ali way off on a 3. And it's a Pirates team that is not a great outside shooting team. But Hanford, as she dribbled the ball up the floor, she touched the end line. So that's a St. John's turnover. Meanwhile, Joe Tartamella, after a decade as the right-hand man to Kim Barnes-Arico, he is now in his second season coaching St. John's.
You know, I think Joe Tartamella advanced to the next level of his coaching after that victory against Texas A&M, and he didn't do it just by talent. He did it with great adjustments and game preparation in that victory in the Maggie Dixon Classic.
Richardson-Smith fouled on the cut. It's Brianna Brown picking up her first. And that could be a game for the St. John's program that came in reeling, having dropped 3 in a row, including losing both games of their Chartwell's Holiday Classic the weekend before to good programs out of the CAA, Drexel and James Madison. But they had never lost both games in their own tournament, as Cook on the follow hit the side of the backboard. And Thompson rebounds. Here is Eugenia McPherson. McPherson to the rim, and the blocking foul underneath.
Oh, That's one thing about St. John's. They're not going to hesitate taking the ball to the rack. And Shota DeMello wants them to get the ball to the rim as soon as they can for a great look. Great penetration here. Eugenia McPherson draws the contact, but a little too late on the charge.
McPherson also making her second straight start of the season. Fifth-year senior out of North Babylon, New York. Missed all but five games last year due to a torn ACL. Played two weekends ago coming off the bench. And then in the game against Texas A&M, started at the point, had a career-high seven assists. It's Tabitha Richardson-Smith put Seton Hall on the board. That's a three.
Well, make that number 30 on the season for her. And now she's got 30 of the 41 three-point shots for Seton Hall.
Ball saved on the wild shot by Brown. And the Pirates looking to push Simmons. Richardson-Smith stepping back. Not there. Ali, another offensive rebound. Janae Johnson from the elbow. Ali, a great offensive rebounder, and she sticks it in, and we're quickly tied at five.
Well, Seton Hall has emerged as one of the elite rebounding teams, not just in the Big East, but in the country. They're averaging 52 rebounds per game, 14 rebound differential over their opposition.
Tony Bazella calls Brashae Ali the best offensive rebounder he's ever coached.
Well, she is tough. She not only has the size, but she has the technique in their box out.
Seton Hall, 11th in the country in rebounding, second in the Big East. Here's McPherson, got a pass to the basket, left that short, and out of bounds off of Thompson.
I think McPherson is going to have a great opportunity tonight. You saw Leah Hanford do it against Texas A&M, getting and splitting the zone, and that's what McPherson needs to do as well.
This is Alexis Brown, a junior from Jacksonville that just checked in for the first time. She's coming back after missing 8 weeks with a broken finger. This is just her second game. Both teams' rosters have been in somewhat of flux and turmoil as that shot wild look from Brown. St. John's getting the two transfers eligible. And the return of Eugenia McPherson, also having a player transfer that was with them in the first semester. While Seton Hall, they have only had their full lineup for just the second game, second time this season, and that's today. They have had games where they've been missing three starters. Pass on the lob to Hanford, and she was fouled.
And that's how athletic Aaliyah Hanford is. When Aaliyah Hanford can get behind the defense, she is one of the best in the Big East. And when she gets to the basket, she can finish with the best of them.